it sucks, guys. It really does suck. Fortunately, we made some moves, etc. And we kind of saw, knew that the type of content that we make, for us to be able to give you this content, we have to.
Comes at a cost,
It comes at a cost,
and it
dude.
won't be here forever.
Yeah,
And
and
we know that going
Fresh
into it.
always said this. Enjoy us while you can.
Yeah, they thought we was capping, man.
Yeah.
They thought it was a joke.
And we made moves on the side, knowing that this could potentially happen. And guys, the channel has been kicked off the YouTube Partner Program. Just keep it straight with
If you look
y'all.
right now, you can't even super chat or
You
become
can't
a
even super
member.
chat right now.
Yep. So this is
The beginning of the end of this era.
So we are in trolling chat, so
Yeah.
yeah.
So you literally can't. Yeah, man. So it's so basically, we're gonna figure out what's going on, because we don't even really know all the details. We're working with YouTube to try to come to a middle ground and work together and figure this out. But for now,
We don't even know
obviously,
why.
we
Yeah.
don't know the specific reason.
Dearly beloved, we gather today for the passing of Unfresh and Unfit. For they are now leaving us with unsavory memories and very traumatic experiences on the YouTube app. We do not wish them well. However, we will take this as a learning experience. Amen. Comment down below. Amen. I'm gonna skip the intro because y'all already know who the fuck it is. I'm the Mademoiselle. This is my channel. And yes, I'm late to this because honestly, I kept forgetting to film this video. Because to be honest with you, I don't be paying any attention to anybody in the rainbow community. Yes, the rainbow community. And I'm not talking about that rainbow. I'm talking about that rainbow, okay? The rainbow pill community. Red pill, pink pill, purple pill, blue pill. I don't even know what pill belongs to who, because that's how much I don't pay attention to any of these communities. However, this, I heard about it and I was like, oh my God, it's a funeral. That's the main reason I put on my black and white today. But I was like, you know what, let me keep it on. I have my all black, look at that. Black everything out, because it's a funeral. I need to start a series called Iced Tea where I just essentially talk about things late, because I'm very late to the party. But it's okay. I know y'all want to hear my opinions about it. It's not too late now, is it? Y'all be alright. Now, of course, y'all already know Unfresh and Unfit have been kicked out of the YouTube Partner Program, and they are not happy about it. Now, let me just say that this is the beginning of the end of all the rainbow communities, but most specifically the men in the rainbow pill communities, okay? And I say this specifically because these rainbow pill communities have been extremely detrimental to all the men, women, and children all over the goddamn world, especially on the internet, okay? And I don't give a damn if y'all men think y'all are saving other men and if y'all women think y'all are saving other women, because all of y'all are problematic as hell, okay? That's why I don't fuck with none of y'all. Like, I don't care. And that's why a lot of y'all don't like me. Y'all be talking about some Kama, and come say that. Yeah, I said what I said. I meant what I said, and I'll say that shit again. I don't give a fuck about none of y'all motherfuckers. And I don't like none of y'all motherfuckers. You guys are detrimental to every single person that comes across y'all channels, okay? And I'm so happy that everyone is finally starting to see that there's a problem with these types of channels. It's very interesting, because literally a lot of you guys always send me these types of videos. You're like, oh, are you gonna say something? Oh, this person reacted to you. Oh, this person put you in their video. Are you gonna say? I don't pay attention to these types of videos. There's a reason these videos don't pop up in my feed. Why are they popping up in your feed? They don't pop up in my feed. Do they pop up in your feed? Do they pop up in your feed? They don't pop up in my feed because I don't pay attention to that type. type of content. I don't watch that type of content. I don't pay attention to these type of clowns. These type of people are nowhere near my type of caliber. I do not talk hateful rhetoric, okay? A lot of this content is hateful. A lot of it is spiteful. A lot of it is disgusting. A lot of it is filled with people that need to heal. I can't. It's just too much for me. I have enough problems in my life. I cannot sit there listening to a bunch of whiny incels who literally need to get a life, get a wife, or get a husband, right? I just can't. It's just too much for me. All right, so of course, we're here to talk about Unfresh and Not Fit, all right? It is very interesting that this shit is going on because I know that it's gonna be the beginning of the end, specifically because when I went to YouTube like not too long ago, they kind of started running down things to us and started telling us what's gonna be allowed, what's not gonna be allowed, and what they're gonna start cracking down on. And I was like, oh. So let me just say straight up, right? I'm not happy about anyone losing their money, losing their job, and losing their place as a content creator on this platform or any platform. That shit is hard, okay? Being a content creator is hard. I don't understand why people think it's easy to be a content creator. I don't understand why people think it's easy to build a following. I don't know why people think it's simple work or it's nothing to do what we do, or that doing what we do is just like bullshit, and that like essentially we should just be happy and lucky to have this job, and all we do is sit in front of the camera all day and run our mouths and basically get paid for it. Trust me, it's not that easy. Some days money comes easy, some days money don't come in at all. I've had times where I couldn't pay my rent. I've had times where I couldn't pay my car note, whatever the case may be. A lot of us are regular people, while some of us make a bulkoop amount of money, while some of us can be vice versa and still not see any money or still see a lot of money. It really, really depends. Nonetheless, I'm not happy that they lost their monetization, and I don't think it's okay for anyone else to be happy that they lost their monetization. Even though I know a lot of y'all are doing the cha-cha in your living rooms and still doing the cha-cha celebrating and probably gonna be celebrating for the rest of y'all lives, that essentially they lost their monetization. And to be honest, I can't even blame y'all. They've done and said some very, very disgusting things about women on their channels, about some other creators on their channels. So I cannot blame y'all. I'm not even gonna say that. I'm just gonna say I'm not happy about it. However, I will say specifically, I'm not gonna even sit here and parade around and be like, yes, that's why y'all lost y'all channel, da da da. Like, no. But I'm gonna say I'm not shocked, because YouTube be warning us, especially when you go to events, like when you go to YouTube events, when you know people at YouTube and stuff like that, like they be telling you like, all right, this is what we don't like, this is what's coming, this is what we're planning. So it's not too shocking. Now, a lot of you guys are probably thinking, okay, well, clearly their content is what got them removed from the YouTube Partner Program. Their language got them removed. It was all of the misogyny, etc. To be quite honest, yes and no. Let's be real here. There is a lot of that content here on YouTube, both on the female side and the male side. But to be honest with you, it's way worse on the male side. And I will say that YouTube is very much so pick and choose whoever they want to remove for whatever it is that they want. So it's pretty obvious that they've been seeing their content for a long time, but never decided to do anything about it. But let's be real here. When you really look at their content, they were just doing a little bit too much. So for starters, one, YouTube does not like you try and navigate people away from their platform. They absolutely hate it. As a matter of fact, like, it actually is a risk to have like social media links in your description. Like I do, and I've been doing it for years, even though I probably shouldn't, but it is what it is. But those are not major competitors of YouTube. If you guys ever notice with Unfresh and Not Fit's channel, they literally have Rumble, a direct competitor of YouTube, on their videos nonstop, all the time, all live streams, all videos. That is a direct YouTube competitor. Are you dumb or are you dumb? Why would I go on Twitter advocating for people to go to my threads? Same thing with Facebook. If you go on Facebook and you post YouTube videos and you're like, hey guys, go on my YouTube, they're gonna suppress it because YouTube is a direct Facebook competitor. You don't go on the competitor's website peddling the competitor. You don't do that shit. So that's number one. Number two, these clowns were were not only disrespectful to women and many other creators, okay? We all know about the ABBA and Peach drama, which I'm not even gonna get into that because then we gonna be sitting here for too damn long. They were out here putting on CCC costumes. Put two and two together. CCCK costumes. Yes, putting on Klansmen costumes, ladies and gentlemen. Putting on Gorilla Ape costumes, ladies and gentlemen. What does that make YouTube look like if they're allowing that type of shit on their platform? It's bad enough that y'all talking shit about women, y'all talking shit about other YouTubers in such a foul manner, and then you guys have the nerve, gall, audacity to bring people on that platform to degrade and berate them, and then you're putting on CCC costumes and gorilla costumes. YouTube cares about their reputation. It may seem like they don't, but they do. And even if for whatever reason they demonetize you or, you know, delete your channel, whatever the case may be, sometimes it is on accident. I will say that. Cause like YouTube has suppressed my channel before. I did a whole video about that before where they basically gave me this rating, which basically like suppressed my channel and made it so like a lot of you guys were not getting my notifications for like almost a year. It was so fucking annoying, and I had to contact them for that. I had to hit up somebody on YouTube. Y'all, it was a whole thing. And sometimes that could be triggered by just a video or so. Sometimes it could be triggered by your comment section. It happens all the time. Same thing how now there's a lot of YouTubers who like have kids, who have family channels, who now don't have comment sections, specifically because now their channels are automatically marked kids when it's not for kids. They just happen to have kids on their channel. So sometimes, yes, the algorithm does make mistakes. Sometimes the algorithm will sit there and be like, oh, danger, stranger danger. Ooh, suppress, ooh, demonetize, ooh. And you can hit up YouTube and tell them like, oh, can you tell me why my thing is whatever? Because I had to do that and everything's decent now. However, in this case, that is no mistake. They know exactly what they were doing. And like I said, it's the beginning of the end. There's too many of these channels who have picked up a pitchfork against their own people, okay? In particular, Black people. There's too many of y'all who have picked up a pitchfork against your own people, who have sat here and thought it's okay to make content dragging Black women, dragging Black men, who think that this content is going to resonate with your audiences. And shockingly, for whatever reason, it does. And I know there's gonna be a lot of you, oh, well, Black men started it. They abso-fucking-lutely did. And now all of y'all have made your beds and you guys are going to lay in it. This is not going to be the first or the last one. That is just to make an example. I guarantee it. Thank God Kevin Samuels is rolling in the dirt right now, because I guarantee you his channel would have been demonetized as well. But even at that, Kev Samuels is more so a lot less bad than them, because at least he wasn't out here wearing costumes, making fun of people, bringing people on there to drag them. He was giving advice that they asked for. They were willingly going on there to get advice. And then on top of that, he wasn't out here promoting a competitor. So maybe he would have still been monetized. And honestly, if we're being real here, they need to be lucky that they still have their channel. YouTube is known to just have people wake up and have their channels be wiped. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, YouTube is petty like that. Like, they will just poop your whole channel and not say a damn thing to you. Okay, so I mean, at least they still have their channel. They can definitely monetize other ways, merchandise, Patreon, whatever the case may be. So it's not the complete end all be all. It's just very interesting because now, since they've made such disturbing content that is very disrespectful to so many people, there's no way they can go back to their day jobs. One was working in tech while the other one was working a government job. Where the fuck do you think they're about to take your ass back at? One was literally forced to quit his job and chose to do YouTube instead. They're not taking you back. Literally talk about something, oh, I love saving the kids, but I like saving you guys more. Something's genuinely wrong with you men. I need to make sure if I have a son, they never turn out like y'all. This shit is crazy. What's even more interesting about this is I know there's going to be a lot of people that try to equate this to, you know, censorship and, you know, companies trying to take over and tell us what to do and whatever the case may be. But to be honest, these companies can do whatever the hell it is that they want with their platforms. I'm not mad at it anymore. It's like, it is what it is. It's disappointing. And I wish that YouTube just give people reasons why they do things. I feel like if anything, they should at least give them a reason. But this is their platform. They could do whatever it is that they want with their platform. However, it is gonna be interesting to see down the line who else ends up getting demonetized or or kicked off the platform. There's been a lot of people I know who have had their channels deleted or who have been demonetized for having very touchy opinions or who have just like, I don't know, said or done things to people that they just really didn't like. To get your channel deleted or demonetized, you have to get a lot of reporting. Like, people have to report the hell out of your shit, or you just gotta really do some really salacious things, because again, YouTube don't play about their image, baby. Like, they're not going to let you have their platform in bad press. And the way that they were out here doing all of that goofy shit, they would have been on CNN real quick. I mean, if those videos are still up, someone somewhere one day, a journalist, a nosy ass journalist, gonna come across their videos and be like, the misogyny on YouTube is rampant, and then boom. Hey, I believe it, okay? Because there's too much to pull from on YouTube, okay? And it's not even, again, it's not even just them, okay? And it's not even just the Black community, because I've come across too many videos with other people of other races and ethnicities just dragging women, okay? Dragging men and just saying all types of goofy shit. And I'm like, oh my God, next thing you know, the gender war is insane. I'm like, oh my God, they have too much to pull from on the internet, especially YouTube. Too much. I've reacted to them here. So when you really think about it, again, this is not gonna be the last, okay? They just happen to be a really big channel. There's a lot of smaller channels, so we shall see. With that being said, let me know what you guys think down below. Do you guys think that they should have been demonetized? Do you guys think that their channel should have been deleted altogether? Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Check out my other two channels. Everything is gonna be linked down below. Love you guys so very much. Join my Patreon. It's only $5. You get dedicated uploads, early access, and a dedicated Discord. And I'ma see y'all next time. Bye!